know their voices.
Hey, it's Gina Birch. You're listening to Sunny 106.3.
And trust their reputations.
Your chance to win and win big here on the radio show.
But your favorite local radio DJs are sounding the alarm over a new scam.
We have enough scams and bad things going on in the world, and we don't want that to happen to you.
You might dial in dreaming of winning a prize giveaway, but scammers are cashing in on your good faith.
It's our big story tonight at 7. Thanks so much for joining us on ABC 7. I'm Megan Miller.
And I'm Jeff Harris. ABC 7's Dave Elias is getting you more on how scammers are using popular radio personalities and their voices to trick you.
Well, radio stations like B1039 are warning their listeners that this scam targets their local disc jockeys. And now they're warning their listeners so they don't become the next victim.
Hey, everybody, Stan and Haiti, 96K Rock.
Local radio stations.
Hey, it's Gina Birch. You're listening to Sunny 106.3. And
warning their listeners.
Be aware of fake social media accounts pretending to be us.
They're being targeted by familiar voices.
I've been in Southwest Florida since the mid-90s.
So people know and trust Sunny 106.3's Gina Birch.
We have listeners and people who trust us in the media, and despite what other people think. And I hate that somebody would use the media, TV, radio, to scam somebody.
Scammers notifying listeners they've just won a contest.
Your chance to win and win big.
Scammers are going and starting fake social media accounts, reaching out to different listeners, telling them that they won a prize, and then direct them to a website to ask them to put their credit card information in.
A.J. Lurie manages Beasley Broadcasting. He's worried that scammers could use AI technology to clone those trusted voices.
It's a huge concern, and that's why we're trying to do everything we possibly can to stay in front of it.
Reminding listeners that they will never ask for anything in exchange for a prize.
Stay safe, stay vigilant, and thanks for listening to B1039.
Now, if you believe you may be a victim of this scam, the best advice is to reach out to your local radio station. They'll put you in touch with the authorities. In Estero, Dave Elias, ABC 7.
Let's get you more. According to the FTC, victims have lost more than $6 billion to impersonation scams since 2018. Most crooks pose as government officials or a well-known person, like a celebrity or your favorite radio DJ. Here are some red flags you can look out for. Any request involving gift cards, wire transfers, or cryptocurrency should be shut down immediately. Typos or strange spellings in messages or websites can also signify a scam. And always, if the offer sounds too good to be true, it probably is.
Nuisance 6 clues.